Hey, what's going on, ladies and gents? Welcome back to another Genshin Impact video. Guys, today we're going to be talking about a few reasons why I think Inazuma is going to be coming out after 1.6 version of the Genshin Impact game. And let's just get straight into it. I've compiled some reasons on why the next update would be Inazuma. So many say that it's probably the patch after that, but I have some evidence to state or to assume that it is going to be the patch after 1.6. So let's just begin with the teasers that they have shown us. The first thing is the teaser before 1.5 during the live stream, in which they showed us the main city and how it looks with a simple image, meaning they have already had the concepts and the buildings and everything being worked on at the time period. I think that's really cool that they did that, because that shows us that they are, you know, working on it. And since, you know, they're teasing that, leakers can't really say, oh, Inazuma is going to be coming in this date and this time, because they just teased it to show us, oh, we're working on it, be prepared, it's coming soon. And I feel like that's really good for us Genshin Impact players to have something to look forward to in the game, rather than just, you know, free falling into the abyss, I suppose. This also gives us the impression that they probably worked on Inazuma even before the game first came out, because, well, it's there, the building was there, they showed us the images and everything like that, especially after Leeway, with the whole Leeway quests and everything. They tease Inazuma every now and then, especially at the end of Zhongli's whole dilemma, Archon quest, and whatever it may be. So I feel like that's pretty cool of the game and pretty cool of miHoYo to do that. Speaking before the game first came out, don't you remember the time we thought Inazuma was going to come out around 1.2, but rather we got Dragon Spine? Well, it's because I think it was delayed from all the profits and stuff that they got, especially after us getting a whole roadmap, and then they're saying, oh, the roadmap's actually going to be extended for 10 years instead of 5, which is nuts in my opinion, but it is what it is. Continuing on, the teasers in 1.6 livestream were first telling us about Beidou helping us out in the quest to get into Inazuma, especially because Beidou is like a quote-unquote pirate. You know, she goes on a boat, she has her own crew and everything. She states or shows us that it's going to be a treacherous path. It's going to lead to many perils whilst trying to get into Inazuma, you know, using the boat or whatever it may be to get over there. So that's the first thing they go over. So yeah, that's the first thing they go over. With that, we also find out about Kazuha, which is also involved with all of this, since he was picked up by Beidou in her own fleet. Kazuha became a traveler, a wanderer, because he was kicked out of Inazuma, he was hunted by the Inazuma Fetui, the Inazuma police, I guess you could say that. So he was kicked out, so he became a wanderer, picked up by Beidou, and then now we have Kazuha in Beidou's fleet. So whatever it was that happened that made this happen, we now have Kazuha as a character that's going to be just coming out before 1.7. I feel like that's an insane hint. It's just so big, a whole character from Inazuma coming out before Inazuma even comes out. That's pretty big. The first thing they go over is that it's probably the prologue. So even though we get Inazuma, we won't get the entire Archon quest for Inazuma, which kind of sucks, and we have to wait a long time for that. I really am disappointed that's the way of the game, but it is what it is, and I hope they do release it more often or sooner, just so I can go over it with you. Since they hinted that since 1.5, the whole image teaser, and they hinted the prologue in 1.6, showing us Beidou's quest, and then releasing Kazuha, and also releasing a new Inazuma boss, which is a weird Yaksha looking samurai that came from Inazuma or made from Inazuma just for us to fight. It's showing us all the probabilities of Inazuma coming sooner than some anticipate. It is so evident beyond a reasonable doubt. Although, I will state that, again, this is all speculation and speculation only. Alright, so we also get a teaser at the end of 1.6 livestream showing us Ayaka, a new Sword Cryer user that will come out in 1.7 for Genshin Impact. Also, she talks about all the islands and the archipelago in Inazuma, and also telling us all about the special regions and things that go on in the island. She tells us about the all treacherous islands and the, you know, lightning and the storm and whatever it may be. So, I mean, that pretty much sums all of this in total. I mean, that's all I had to talk about. And I personally think that it is going to occur sooner rather than later, especially how they run this patch in such a fashion that I feel like they would release it on 1.7. But I have no idea. It is miHoYo. They could do whatever they want. Honestly, they are pretty much set. Anyway, multiple things solidate that this patch might have it, but it is what it is, and I honestly cannot wait for it all. Tell me what you guys think will be coming in 1.7 or the new version of Genshin Impact after 1.6, especially if you think 1.7 is going to have Inazuma released alongside it. Tell me and let me know in the comments down below. Anyways guys, thanks for watching as always, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to subscribe to my channel as well as like the video as well. See you guys in the next video. Goodbye.